are here for configuration management for your story. Could be some assumptions made that you know this is complete and correct. Before the export, you want to get into the pretty high level of what John mentioned. But for configuration management, you want to be yourself. So I'm making that I'm a senior developer from a really distributed agency across the world. We work with very large publishing companies, just really complex components. I'm a organizer of Drupal projects, which can be a project for us to support code and development. So with that chromatic integration, we follow a flow that takes our features and their platforms, not specifically into them, but desiring to be so we consider configuration code to include the integration code. We can export that to the CMS files and use them to create a CMS pipeline. So in this example, we're returning that code to the OE script, meaning that it starts with the code box and to the actual test with the content. As John said, it's a database. The content considers those two also considered files to the package that you upload the box directory. That should always be put there.
So then we have talked about those different types of configuration. Fields, request individual models, every individual model is yes, the request individual model is yes, the one that has completely
So John, I'm making a database in the other file, so we're going to talk about where the database is stored. First off, Drupal considers what they call a package configuration for the configuration of the file model. That's stored in the database. But the reason why that's stored in the database is because of Drupal that is with one of the performance features. I've already done that in this case before. Loading the configuration for the file system. But really, it's a great file database. Loading the file and also that's the future of the thing. After making them to the UI, So, configuration is stored in the file system. That's considered state configuration. And as John said, I think the rest of the slides are going to look like a raw effort. So, for this, yes, this is pretty much state configuration. So changing the state configuration when you apply the import them to the library UI, which is going to make the system work. Benefits of this are portability, so you can export configurations and move them to different environments. Security, my file system, I have a whole system for the developer to get the modified method. And once you can put these changes into the database, so this is the part of the thing that everybody likes to see here, and it's probably most difficult to wrap your head around when you see these configurations for a module. So the configurations for a module is a distributed module. It changes functionality, so it needs to put filter modules, which hooks into the events and hooks that Core provides to alter the things called the export process or you can just set up the entire function. And this is where you start to see differences between the different applications, like we talked about talking to that flow. We had some different approaches that are somewhat similar. And that's what we're going to talk about. So the thing here with so what we do is instead of putting up our environment, we put up our features so that our developers for local Wi-Fi batches that are production that are stored. I'm going to feature flip. framework that's the same software as the system. But what you would do here, instead of having an environment specific, that's what we said. We do our file configuration override and stack that so here we have a comparison of the environment split and the feature split directory. So you can see here that you have a common directory and your environment split, and you can see the environment of the directory for the environment split. We have the title here labeled for dev, we have the title for local, and for API for so if we're on with the first local or file overflow, here we just have an overview of what the sense box for these four for. So the environment splits are very simple. You can use a set of file. You activate a split based on the some environment context. Here I just have some if you look at the feature split, however, you'll notice that in this case, we have four splits. If you have a say 20 split and you need to make a disabled input environment, your settings file can get a little more complicated, as well as having a something to note here, though, that those workflows can follow is that you can fix splits themselves in the configuration or at least in the box, and they're all enabled in settings that you can see. This makes from our experience a lot of you So yeah, you may be asking yourself why these guys are crazy. They're not a lot of their products have some configuration, especially some of these plugs want people to perform in configuration. And you do want to work on those people that have the power to code for. So configure north is great for this. So configure north allows you to ignore configuration keys based on like a flag card or pattern. Even ignore any residual housing configuration. This module actually has a really helpful help text that you can do if you want to set this up. But, you know, we're pretty aware of one for each of the user settings here, you can go through that. We did this talk about 6 months ago back in November, and one thing that came out of it was, people were like, wow, that's a great presentation, I like this module. How can we get configured on the existing source form? I want to whitelist, so I want to ignore the web form. I'm still unable to edit my web form because it's just the same thing. So I operated a module called the configured door configuration, a very specific name. It's fairly simple. Here's a single hook. What it does is it takes the list of configuration entities that you're ignoring and the whitelist that may configure them. So if you ignore all the web form controls from all your web form, and by the way, before we do that, both Chromatic, from the back end engineers, both hiring most developers to be on the list, and you can feel kind of a little bit much. So feel free to check out our project website. Sure question. So that was the caveat with especially the previous one that you want. So what it's doing is taking this wild card pattern, it's converting it to regular expressions and not so that's a good question. We've left some work with a couple of clients that want that power. The problem is that if you want to have continuous performance where you have to see, you know, merging and pulling your master branch of the fault range to automatically pull into production, you can't stop that because not every developer can remember to pull that back up. So here, I guess, plays with a bunch of mechanics that both of our teams can continue to play with the system. So we actually don't really have a bunch of these tests. Oh, we tell the developer that we're going to pay merge into that system. It's not out of the
So,
Thanks for coming in.